It's been nearly 2,000 years since Julius Caesar and his army appeared on the horizon. That's 2,000 years of history, progress, and war. 2,000 years of living and dying, and the construction of a city. Who knew then that this little island on the River Seine would one day become Paris? The modern-day metropolis was once the medieval capital of the Western world. It was the royal seat of the most powerful monarchy ever known, and the theater of a revolution which defies comparison. It was the center of an empire, a commune, a republic, and a key city in Hitler's twisted vision of Europe. The history of Paris reads like a history of Western civilization. It was for centuries considered to be the center of the world and is known to this day as the most beautiful city in it. Not surprisingly then, the tourists come in droves. They climb to the top of the Eiffel Tower and they think they've seen it all, but they haven't even scratched the surface. The Eiffel Tower is like the tip of the iceberg. Beneath Paris, there is another Paris, a vast subterranean world unlike any other on Earth. It is a secret world and a forbidden world. A nearly endless labyrinth of darkness, harsh and unforgiving to the unprepared. In the late 18th century, an unfortunate explorer was hopelessly lost as his candle burnt to its end. He was found 11 years later. His tombstone is the only one beneath Paris, but he is hardly alone. 6 million human skeletons, more than the population above, are piled into forgotten caverns. Descend beneath Paris, and you won't believe your eyes. The spacious caverns of the ancient quarries, where stone was taken from the earth and hoisted to the heavens. The resulting voids were forgotten, but not forever.
Donc ce sont deux gros secteurs de Paris quand même qui s'écroulaient, et on avait les Parisiens avaient l'impression que tout Paris risquait de s'écrouler, puisqu'on n'avait pas conscience de là où avaient eu lieu toutes les exploitations. On pensait que tout Paris était creux.
All told, Paris experienced more than 2,000 cave-ins. Most were minor, but some were entire streets. Immediate action was imperative, so while disaster continued to strike, a systematic search was on for lost quarries. Under each and every street, a narrow gallery was dug, effectively creating a second Paris, 90 feet below.
Paris a cette particularité, c'est que l'ensemble des carrières qui sont sous la ville de Paris ont été reliées entre elles par un réseau de galeries qui a été créé par l'inspection des carrières. Ce réseau est unique au monde, il n'y a aucune autre ville qui a un réseau comme ça, qui double un peu les rues qu'il peut y avoir en surface.
It was a realm of intense suspicion, dark and destined to play its part in the turbulent passage of time. After centuries of revolution, two world wars, these tunnels have a tale to tell. German writings on the wall still speak of the Nazi occupation. The various bunkers and executive shelters of the Third Reich lie dormant beneath the surface. Eerie, haunting, they attest to a time gone by.
J'ai vraiment conscience quand je descends sous terre de remonter dans le temps et de d'avoir cette chance de circuler dans une tranche d'histoire qui est figée depuis 200 ans sous Paris.
Paris's rocky realm is but one layer of its subterranean world. By simply following the crowd, you will find yourself underground, in the metro, amidst an entire century of subterranean circulation. We take it for granted today, but this was once the talk of the town. It was a test of modern engineering, a source of fear and shelter alike, an intense negotiation, not to mention a major controversy. Ever wondered where it all goes, or what life was like before it went there? Then journey to the most famous sewers in the world, just beneath the streets of Paris.
Seem to respond to people's greatest fears and greatest disgust, of course. I mean, these are what we would expect. But instead of it being simply a world of fear and disgust, it became a magical world.
Gaze deeply into the murky flow and take a moment to appreciate the fact that what you see here is not on the streets. Medieval Paris, to the contrary, was a drainage nightmare. Spring showers flooded the unpaved alleys, and plague flourished in the stinking mud. By the end of the Renaissance, the existing sewers were in such pitiful shape that something had to give. Les Misérables. Victor Hugo's masterpiece immortalized the Parisian underworld.
This way.
Be smarter than that. You'll go downhill to the river. Come on.
It was uncharted land of crime, waste, and disgust. And through it, our hero flees, wading neck deep in the raw truth of society.
For Hugo, the tricky thing for him was that he was exiled, and he writes Les Misérables when he's in exile, and at the very time that he is basically saying the condition of the sewers reveal the condition of society, Usman is rebuilding the French sewers so that they become this, basically by 1870, by the end of the empire, they're a tourist attraction. And it undercuts Hugo. It really was a marvel. After all, in 1832, and again in 1848, France had a severe cholera epidemic, and the cholera epidemic was associated, quite rightly, with the sanitation, with the sewers. And so the idea that 20 years later, by 1867, you were taking your dignitaries, and in the act, they had no Tour Eiffel, they had no Eiffel Tower at the time, so they're taking them to the sewers, seemed astonishing. I mean, why would you take the Queen of England to the sewers?
It was, in fact, a display of victory, a celebration of triumph 2,000 years in the making. Effective drainage was here at last, and it meant a lot at the time. But nowadays, it's all taken for granted. The earth is not collapsing, the streets are sanitary, and the metro is, well, a routine. In this sense, Paris could be compared to any major city, but that would be a mistake. There's no place under earth quite like Paris. Nowhere more diverse, massive, mysterious, and yet revealing. Only in Paris does the underground have such a tale to tell. A story of revolution, monarchy, and mayhem. A story of life and love, witchcraft and science. A story of government and scandal, art and espionage. Population, pollution, and transportation This is the story of a capital city entering a modern era. It is the story of drainage and a society triumphing over its own waste. It is the story of stone mining and the building of a city like none other. All of this is under Paris. This is the 2,000-year epic of the city above, told by what lies below. Follow the tunnels, and they will lead you through history.